Hello and welcome. In this video, we're going to use mathematical induction to prove that 2 to the power of 3n minus 3 to the power of n is divisible by 5 for all natural numbers or n is greater than or equal to 1. The first step of mathematical induction is always the basis test, which is to see if this condition or expression holds true for n is equal to 1. I'll put a question mark because we're just going to test if it is true or not. So if n is equal to 1, then I get 2 to the 3 times 1 minus 3 to the power of 1. And that's equal to, 2 to the power of 3 is 8, and 3 to the power of 1 is 3. So I'll get 8 minus 3, which is equal to 5. And is 5 divisible by 5? Yes, it is. So the basis test validates this condition. Now, because we found that this statement is true for n equals 1, I'm going to assume that it holds true when n is equal to any integer. So I'm going to assume true for n is equal to k. So I get 2 to the 3k minus 3 to the k is equal to 5 multiplied by j. So this simply means that on the right hand side we have 5 multiplied by any integer, or the right hand side basically means I get any multiple of 5 which is divisible by 5. So I'll say j is any natural number. And I note that this equation can imply that 2 to the 3k is equal to 5j plus 3k. And this step will become important later on. Okay, now the second major step of mathematical induction is the inductive test. So I've assumed that if this statement is true for n is equal to k, does it hold true for when n is equal to k plus 1, or when I go to the next number? So if I substitute in n is equal to k plus 1, I'll get 2 to the 3 times k plus 1 minus 3 to the power of k plus 1. And that can be written as 2 to the 3k plus 3. So I just expand, distribute this out, and I get 3k minus 1. And if I just use my index laws to simplify, I'll get 2 to the 3k times 2 to the 3 minus 3k times 3, which is equal to 8 by 2 to the 3k minus 3 times, minus 3 times 3 to the k. Right, here's where this expression becomes important. So 8 is now outside of 5j plus 3 to the k minus 3 by 3 to the k. If I expand that out, I'll get 40j plus 8 times 3k minus 3 times 3k. And well, 8 times 3k minus 3 times 3k, that will give me 5 times 3k, or 3 to the k I should say, and 40j remains. Now, if I factor out a 5, I will get inside of brackets 8j plus 3 to the k. Well, this term inside of the parentheses or the brackets will always work out to be a whole number if j and k are natural numbers, which they are. And we've got a whole number multiplied by 5, which means it is going to be divisible by 5. So we have proven by mathematical induction that the expression 2 to the 3n minus 3n is divisible by 5 for all natural numbers, so for all n is greater than 1. And that's all we're required to do. So please give me a thumbs up if this video has helped you better understand how to use mathematical induction. If you are a math student, please feel free to subscribe for future videos that may help you on assignments or exams. If you have any question that you would like me to do a video on, please feel free to comment on any of the videos that you've seen. Thanks for watching, and I hope you learned something.